going soft on me, Blight?
In your dreams.
Now introducing our
only for you. Hey there, hi there, holder, and welcome to another Narjum Reacts. In this video, we're reacting to Owl House Season 1, Episode 16. Now, before we begin, I have been told by a few of you that this episode is like a prom episode, and Dana, the creator of the show, did request reactors to dress up for that prom night. I don't have a dress or anything like that, but I do have fancier clothes, so I am going to change into those real quick.
Ta-da!
Like I said, I don't have much, but I have some things which I hope make me fancy enough for a prom. But yeah. All right, let me get my headphone on. I'm actually excited for this episode because I'm hoping it has a little bit of, as I now know their ship name as, Illuminati in it. And since it's a prom episode and Luce doesn't really have many friends to go to prom with in the world she's in, so it would have to either be Gus, which I think he's too young, King, another species, maybe she felt like she couldn't go with anyone else, maybe King would go, Amity, or Willow, and I don't think Willow would go. I feel like she'd be too shy, but yeah, without further ado, let's get right into it. The flower, it is. Oh, she's looking at the different glyphs on I Can Grow a Rose. Skills are blossoming. You think that's impressive? Oh, ha, ha. Check this out. Battling to the death. Cats, of course. I still want to know, how is she getting internet in this world? Because from what I've seen so far, there is no internet. But then again, she also has the USB plugged into a wall outlet, I think. So there must be electricity, but I haven't. Why do you need that when you have magic?
I see we're getting enough Wi-Fi through the portal for cat videos.
Senseless violence.
Oh, she's getting it through the Wi-Fi in the portal. That works? Okay.
What possible regrets could come from the internet? Oh, did you know the Earth is actually flat?
Yep, that's not right.
Oh, we actually get to see your mom. It's been what? 16 episodes since we last... No, 15 technically, because the first episode had her in it. So it's been 15 episodes since we last heard from Mama. What if she calls up the camp?
Good enough.
I mean, that's better than what Blitz sent to Solas. He just left him on red.
She will end me.
See, it's funny. My mom, if I ended up in a realm like this, she would get upset, but not for the reasons like what Luce's mom would. My mom would get upset because she'd be like, you've been in this place for how long and you didn't invite me or tell me sooner?
The demon at my shoulder makes a good point.
The demon at my shoulder. Where do you...
Delicious knowledge.
I kind of want to know, where does Hootie keep this kind of stuff stored? Is it like a basement? And that's his stomach? Then what would the attic be, his brain?
The more I look at him, the more uncomfortable I get.
Leave Hootie alone.
Don't spend all day watching YouTube, okay?
YouTube? My own path. They actually mention it in the show. I don't think any of their art cartoons have actually mentioned, like, YouTube itself. They'll say the internet and stuff in videos, but...
Who has the energy?
Who has the energy? I swear, Luce, if you don't invite Amity to the prom, the movie shipper in me is gonna be disappointed.
Did everyone get a haircut?
Oh,
that's
yeah.
What you noticed, Luce. You...
Then, Skara, will you go to prom with me?
Did he have that on him the whole time? Why? Where'd he get the heart from?
I was kicked out of my last school dance for dressing like an otter, but maybe here.
An otter?
Not something people usually sign up for.
Wow, we're starting off with them bumping into each other. Well, Amity bumping into her. Why do I feel like being the queen of Grom means you get sacrificed or something?
Watch it, nitwit. Oh, hi, Luce. And Co.
So feisty still.
No problem. Let me help you.
So she's still really feisty toward, like, other people, but toward, like, Willow, Gus, and Luce, she's not?
Here, your note. Man, you
got is that a Grom letter to someone? Who is it, Amity?
I have the privilege to bestow our highest honor to Amity Blight.
Of course.
Our Grom Queen.
She doesn't look happy, though. It's not what Luce thinks.
Lower the streamers.
Oh my god, they have the spin. What was he called again? Forgot the monster's name. The one from the episode where Ida became the owl form, her owl demon form for the first time. They're using him as a disco lamp? Or a disco ball, not lamp.
Great. 36 more hours.
36? Couldn't you just put him up there for the when it's actually going on?
Well, hello.
Nope, touch the wrench button. Is this for the Grom Queen? It is. She has to fight something.
Where I'll make my debut as Grom Queen. That's Grom.
It's the ooze.
It's a monster that lives under the school.
Weren't they built on top of a previous school?
Every year it tries to break out, and a student has to defeat it before it.
That's not what I expected the Grom to look like. Oh, it takes form of whatever you fear, I bet.
Worries you so much. Why don't you tell Princess
what
Dad
is
you
it?
Want out of this?
Put down a tarp, I'm gonna puke!
Get away from him. Ow! Don't be in this puke zone.
Careful with those pins.
Ida. What? You're wearing a guy's suit?
By doing this, I don't even wear clothes.
Hey, sweet
dad. King, you look like a gardener. That's kind of mean, you guys.
Joke, Luce.
Then again, Amity knows more spells, so.
I could totally handle it.
That's what.
There's a horrifying spider in your hair.
Nope. I'm not as fragile as you think, Ida. And I can't.
There's an actual spider, isn't there?
Either.
That's a camel spider. I recognize those big pincer in that brown coloring anywhere. And the fun thing is they don't really bite unless you, like, grab them. So as long as she just, like, flicks it off, she's good.
You from multiple monsters, remember?
King, you literally were laughing with Ida when Luce has been there for you too.
Facing Grom means facing your worst fear, King, and I don't think Luce knows what that means yet.
She was prom queen, wasn't she?
Do you think I could pull off red eyeshadow?
Girl, you can pull off anything. Up top.
She already got red lipstick.
I'm a bad boy.
Bad boy? What do you mean, bad girl?
This is no problem.
You have magic. Use light. Amity!
Oh my gosh, Amy! I'm so sorry!
Wait, did she just call her Amy? Wait, hold up.
Oh my gosh, Amy! I'm so sorry!
It sounds like Amy, but I hear the Amy. It's like not a Amity, it sounds like Amy. Okay, I don't think she has a nickname for her yet. Yet.
And here I thought this day. Couldn't get any worse.
Yeah, a little close there, didn't you?
Did you talk to Bob?
Did she just plop in the mud with her? Luce, you're too cute.
No. Who'd want to switch with me?
Luce?
I would.
I'll do it. I'll take your place and face.
How noble of you. You're going to die.
Fearless champion. Fearless.
Actually, that's a good way of getting rid of it, is plopping your head in the mud. Actually, no, because if you squish it with your face into the mud, it might pinch. Yeah, no. Never mind. She would have been better off just swiping it off at that point.
Champion.
Is that a peacock moon dress? Is that a FNAF reference? Or is it just a reference to that kind of stuff, period? Chimichurri sandwiches. That makes me hungry. Hi, Hootie.
Hootie, no touching. Bird tube ever talks to me again, I'm going to destroy it. You ready to train?
Don't touch Hootie, please.
This one says witch with a dark side.
Oh wait, I just realized that's the freaking her otter costume. You know, whenever I see that kind of stuff, I just think FNAF automatically. But I think that's just a PJ onesie that's of otter.
Says I'm an otter with a dark side.
Why do you have the chibi like ooh face?
You wanna hear my worst nightmare?
Hootie, you're pushing it.
Will transform
into at least he's a pirate now.
Being alone forever.
He's stuck with you forever.
That's sad. He's like doesn't want to be alone, and probably because he doesn't want to be without his sisters, and then she's just being stuck with you. It's okay. I like the brother more than the sister anyway.
No! I'm lactose intolerant.
Oh, she doesn't drink milk. That's true. We don't know what Luce's actual fear is. So she has to stay. Oh. She's huge. Inadequate. You know that. Hold up. Let me just take a pause on a specific moment here. Just before I say what I want to say. You know there are people that saw this and went, step on me, mommy. Or the death by, okay, I don't want to say anything further because that's just going to taint me and I don't need to see Eden in that way. Thank you very much. Weak baby.
Meow. Still growl. Wait a sec. You're training to be Grom Queen.
So what if I am?
Now, what's the fun in watching a kid get eaten by a monster if it's my kid?
Well, it's my kid. That's cute. To protect her. Oh. Not the human cat. They're all blushing. Of course, Willow's giving them all the flowers. She has a king wristwatch.
So much for Mama's fun night out.
But wait, if she watched the child lose, then they're all gonna suffer nightmares, so she'd have to step in either way.
Our designated splash zones.
For blood. He doesn't want the attention. I was about to say, what the heck was that noise? It's a whoopee cushion. I'm sure you'll be fine, King. What is it for? Who is it for? What is it? Also, you look nice.
Something's making my stomach squirm.
Your hair looks nice. Why do you have like a tutu plus an actual tuxedo and then like hiking boots? Okay, if we could just get rid of the, honestly, just get rid of the tutu and everything else, Lucy would look great.
You going soft on me, Blight? In your dreams.
Now introducing our
only for you.
Luce the human.
I love how they don't use Luce's last name. It's just Luce the human. I love how it goes from like what you think of a usual prom, which is cute romance stuff, and then it's just like, nah, it's a battle to the death. This is like Sparta or Colosseum mixed with prom. Gramorama. Cat noise. Oh, King. That's right. Kings were his co-host. Are those player cards? Or poker cards? Can King even see?
Please?
Oh, poor King.
You're not coming from a
well, he got to face what he fears. Judgment? Oh, she makes spikes now. What's gonna be next? Eda? Oh, it's Ida's. Oh, that's a creepy looking. Oh, it sees what she's actually afraid of. Her mom? It's her mom. She's afraid of, yeah, she's afraid of her mom finding out.
Have you been lying to me?
Oh! Oh my god!
Thing is, you're sitting in my personal chit-chat zone, which means you gotta talk.
Personal chit-chat zone,
that's
cute.
Gross! Why would you do that?
You always do that.
Like Luce is doing right now.
Hi, Luce. Bye, Luce.
Why are you running loose?
I mean, you can't really blame her when it looks like that after. Wait, are they all like jocks or something? No.
So let's follow them and see what happens next.
Are you really narrating this as you go after Luce? I love how the two people that care for her are like running after her. She's going to the edge of the water? Luce. Spicy what? My human.
Stay away from her.
It's gonna read her mind. We're gonna see what she's scared of. Ooh. Do it. Do it. One time I'll want something out. Is herself? What is it? Who is it? Is it an apology note?
That's what friends do.
But wait. No, what did you do? You split the paper in half so we only saw the other half, not the who she was asking. Who was she gonna ask? What if it was loose and it's like, that's why she's like happy? La la? Nice lighting. Oh my god, it's like tango. Oh wow. Why is this so good? Oh. Oh, the plant. Nice. Pretty. Aw. Oh, they get the crowns.
She's blushing. She's blushing.
Ask out. Oh, it's not important.
Yes, it is. It was loose. It was. Yay. Let that ship sail. It was loose. I knew it. I'm happy. Best episode in the series so far.
I'm the king of demons and I've never had stage fright in my life.
Really, king?
Thanks, but I'm gonna go to bed.
Yeah, because she still failed her fear.
Now I am king and queen. Best of both things.
Okay, king. Cute. Just the duck? Oh, so you can still keep up the normal conversation. Just tell the truth in a kind of skewed way. I mean, just show her the place and she won't think you're crazy.
Aw, that's a cute way of saying text.
Wait, are people sending her letters? Wait. Hi, Mom. I'm having a great time at Kansas. Have we learned what mortgages are? I can't wait to get home and see you. Let's do lots of fun mother-daughter activities forever and ever. Love your daughter, Luss. Luce. Who's sending these letters? It's not Amity. I mean, Amity wouldn't even know who her mom is. Don't think it'd be Ida. Plus, I don't think Amity or Luce would misspell Luce's name. Could it be the guy that cursed Ida? But then why would he be interested in Luce? Grom memories. Is that pufferfish guy? Basha, go away. Oh, you too, Methelman. Again, just get rid of the tutu Luce and you'd be great. Oh, there's blushing Amity. You can let go now.
Can someone let me down? Anyone?
Oh my god, he's just left up there. Alright, let me go ahead and get into my thoughts. Alright, so my thoughts for this episode. It is not what I expected for a prom episode. Like, it was, but at the same time it wasn't. But, first off, yay! Lumity is not whole thing, but it is a confirmed thing that Amity does like Luce, so yay. Now, whether Luce will ever feel the same way about Amity, I don't know, but fingers crossed she will. But anyway, okay, so the plot for this episode. I do like how it was handled for a prom episode, because usually prom episodes can be cute, but also cheesy, but not in like a good way. More like a blue cheese stinky way than a Gouda melty kind of cheesy. But I like that, of course, it's its own spin because of the world this exists in. So, of course, it's some kind of creature that's been locked underneath the... What I'm curious is that a creature from the previous school that they destroyed and built on top of? Or is it something that was part of that, too? It's just been sealed there for... I don't know, centuries. But yeah, I like that it's a creature that the prom queen has. It's interesting, there's no prom queen king, it's just prom queen only. That has to defeat it, and it reveals their worst fear. But yeah, I like the plot for this one. The characters, I mean, I like how it dealt with, you see that's like we thought, because of what was going on, that Ida was going to be Luce's worst fear, just because Ida kind of laughed and put her down and saying you're kind of like just a baby with magic, so you're not going to handle it, which Luce is. I mean, Amity is definitely more well-experienced in magic and stuff, so she had a better chance. It's just that her fear really scared her. Whereas Luce, and I like how they did that. They hinted at it in the beginning when they showed Luce texting her mom, and she was worried about that. So they actually, if you pay, like, not paid attention, but if you, I had forgotten honestly about that, so I didn't think to even like mention it. I was like, okay, so yeah, it's Ida, that's her biggest fear, or it's like her fear of being not good enough. But then once they show the text message, I'm like, oh, yeah, that's right. She had the text message with her mom, so of course her biggest fear would be her mom not being happy with where she is, her lying, blah, blah, blah. She's afraid of her mom. So I like that. I like the twist on the whole prom thing. Of course, I love the Lumity stuff that was in this. And then we had a little tiny mini side plot of King saying that he has a fear of stage fright. But then of course after that he goes and Gus is like, oh, I'm glad I was able to help you. He's like, you didn't help me, I did it. It's just like, King, I really hope you have like you've had multiple moments where you've like thought you can handle stuff and you couldn't, and then somebody had to bail you out or help you and they were happy to, but then you're like, ah, you didn't help me, kind of thing. I hope he kind of has an episode where something happens where he has to realize, yeah, you know what, humble yourself some more. I know you call yourself the king of demons, but you could still be humble and say, you know, hey, thanks for your help. Because if it weren't for you, I wouldn't have known what to do. So yeah, I hope we get an episode like that, because the show definitely is very good at developing characters. So I'd be surprised if we don't get something like that. I like also getting to see Amity's fear. Like, I figured it was going to be maybe disappointing her. I actually thought it was going to be like disappointing her parents. But the fact that it's rejection, so I wonder if she had a previous rejection that makes her scared, or that's what causes or has caused her fear of rejection, because she's had it in the past. What I find weird though is, why didn't the Grom creature take form of Luce? Like, it took Luce's mom's form by reading her mind, so why didn't Amity, like, when it read Amity's mind, why didn't it take the form of Luce? Instead, it took the form of, like, a random blob person to not show it. Interesting. Unless that's just something they wanted to keep as a surprise for when the note got revealed that it was Luce. I don't know. I kind of wonder, like, if that was the case, they could have handled it where maybe as it was about to start to transform, either Luce jumped in or Amity broke free and stuff to stop it transforming. I don't know. That seems a little weird to me that it showed Luce's mom but not Luce for Amity. But that's honestly a tiny, tiny little thing. Yeah, and the animation, I love, especially the scene with the animation of the tango fight dancing with Amity and Luce. That was actually creative with how the choreography they did with them and stuff. And also their chemistry was great. I also like the design of the ground creature. It kind of reminded me a mix of like Ditto from Pokemon and like the Spirit Away No Face guy. Reminded me of a combination of those two. Yeah, I would say plot was great, the story was great, characters were great, animation was great. Music, I especially noticed it during the tango scene. Like, I liked it. It was enjoyable. But yeah, hope you guys liked my dress up for prom. I know, but honestly, I was gonna say, you know, it wasn't the best, but after seeing Luce and how Luce looked like a combination of Princess Tutu / the Sugar Plum Fairy, and also like a tuxedo / vampire almost like outfit, I don't feel like weird anymore. I think mine's okay. But yeah, Those are my thoughts for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this reaction. If you'd like early access to my full unedited reactions, go join my Patreon. Link in the description and pinned comment below. But anyway, have a wonderful morning, afternoon, night, and keep burning bright. See ya!